Star Wars is woven into American culture. George Lucas's original trilogy changed movies forever, how they're made, and how we view them. But it's more than a movie series. The story is known to nearly everyone. Maybe not everyone is a fanatic, but if you show someone a picture of Darth Vader or you mention the Force, everyone knows what those things are. When I was a kid, I saw Star Wars for the first time and my life was changed. Since then, I've been a true Star Wars fanatic. Star Wars came into my life at almost the same time as music. I started playing the saxophone the same year I received my first Star Wars trilogy on VHS for Christmas. Through the years, the music of Star Wars became my favorite part of the movies. I watched the movies constantly, memorizing every note of John Williams' superb scores for all three films. In the years following, I was saving up money to buy the soundtracks on CD when they were re-released for the Special Edition trilogy. These CDs had such a profound effect on me that music stopped being an activity that I did at school and started being a part of who I was. Music became the thing that I wanted to do in life, and the music to Star Wars is the key that unlocked so many other musical styles to me. So, being the Star Wars maniac that I was, imagine my excitement when I finally got Super Star Wars for the Super Nintendo. I'll insert a quick warning here about spoilers. Most people have seen the original Star Wars trilogy and are familiar with the plot. If you haven't seen the films or played these games, I'll warn you that the following discussion will contain significant spoilers. So, pause this video and go watch the original Star Wars trilogy in its entirety, in one sitting, and I'll see you back here in about 7 hours or so. Welcome back. The first time that I played this game, I was simply blown away by the title screen and the way the game started just like the movie. There were also cutscenes that included images and dialogue that were similar to the film. This was my chance to play through the adventures that I love so much. But as much as I liked everything about the game, I was still impressed most with the music. I knew every note of John Williams' original score, and while I knew that this was an electronic clone, I also knew that it was a very good clone. All of the melodic and harmonic materials were there, and with the correct instrumentation, even if they were synthesized instruments. While the music was not written for a video game originally, it fit the game very well, thanks to the audio team that worked on these standout platformers. Super Star Wars was released in North America in June of 1992, and because this is an action platform game based on a movie, the staff at LucasArts and Sculpture Software took liberties with the plot. I'm looking at you, Landspeeder Stages. And Sandcrawler Stages. Killing Banthas with a lightsaber. Anyways, these changes and a whole host of others are to be expected in this kind of adaptation. And because of these changes and other factors, the placement of music in the game differed in some cases from its placement in the movie. However, even though some of the music was displaced, it was still very true to the original musical materials. So, who was in charge of taking John Williams' remarkable score and making it work on the Super Nintendo? His name is Paul Webb, and he studied classical guitar at the Manus College of Music. This well-known music school is now part of the New School, which is associated with great composers of the 20th century, like John Cage, Henry Cowell, and Aaron Copland. Webb completed his studies at Manus before the merger with the New School took place. In an interview that I had with Mr. Webb via email for this episode, he describes how he got into video game music like this. I studied classical guitar at Manus and planned to perform and teach, which I did do as a freelancer for several years. Then I got into computers, programming, and computer-based music, which eventually led me to the video game industry. He landed at Sculpture Software and composed there in the days of the NES and the SNES. He composed the music for several games including Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, Daydreaming Davy, and Metal Mech on the NES, as well as contributions to Tecmo Super NBA Basketball and WWF Super WrestleMania on the Super Nintendo. He wrote music for games on the Genesis, Game Boy, and computers as well. One of his computer scores came up during the interview. I was very happy with the music of Stratosphere, Conquest of the Skies. I did the majority of music for the original PC version of this game. The game has a strange history. It was originally developed by Sculptured Software, but when Sculpture was bought by Acclaim, sad day, the game was completed by Kodiak. He was also an audio software engineer who was very familiar with the hardware limitations of the equipment that he was using. Knowing the audio specifications of the hardware was critical to composers of that time in writing music that will work and work well on the system. Webb describes his approach to writing NES music like this. I digitally sampled all of the tones and noises that the NES sound chip could make and loaded them onto my sampling keyboard. Then I composed music from the keyboard with Cakewalk Sequencer, later converting it to the NES. That way I knew exactly what it would end up sounding like. He is mostly known for his work on the Super Star Wars trilogy. For these games, he wasn't the composer. He's what musicians call an arranger. An arranger is a musician that takes a previously existing piece of music and makes it work for another voice, instrument, or ensemble. It takes special skill to find the most important musical elements and ensure that they come across effectively in a new context. Webb had already had experience arranging Star Wars scores, working on Star Wars and The Empire Strikes Back on the Nintendo Entertainment System, but the superior sound capabilities of the SNES made for a better quality result. For the Super Nintendo trilogy, Webb took the forces of the entire orchestra and reduced it to a very small size. Whether an arranger is expanding, reducing, or revoicing the music, it takes a lot of knowledgeable work to do, and Webb did a great job reducing the original work in these three games. By the time Super Star Wars was in development, Webb was already familiar with John Williams' score. In fact, while he was working on the NES game based on The Empire Strikes Back, he had access to John Williams' original score. Webb says it best. In fact, when we did the NES version of Empire Strikes Back, LucasArts actually sent me the real, original score that John Williams used to conduct the music, not a copy, with his notes in it. We did send it back when I was done. With the Super Nintendo Star Wars, they sent the published version of the full conductor's scores. The great music begins at the title screen. This music comes from the throne room scene at the end of A New Hope. I arranged the throne room music and some of the closing credits music for the game credit roll, but Peter liked it so much that he made it the music that played whenever the game is started. Throughout the game, the detail of the arranged music continues to impress. Here are excerpts from the music in the game, followed by the orchestral versions of the official film soundtrack. I'll include the names of the tracks from the official film soundtrack as well as a description of where the music can be found in the film. Also, several stages from the game share the same music. I'll also include that information as well. Thank you. There it is. Super Star Wars is a great Super Nintendo action platformer with some excellent arrangements of John Williams' film score. In fact, and this is my own opinion, I believe that the score for A New Hope is the greatest film score ever written. It's in the Wagnerian tradition, and its beautiful narrative sounds like the works of Gustav Mahler and Richard Strauss pulled together by Williams' skill with matching music to motion picture. Paul Webb did an outstanding job here. The game continues to receive favorable reviews, as it did back when it was released, but many gamers have said that this game was difficult. Well, if Super Star Wars is difficult, then the next game in the trilogy is going to put your controller and anything breakable in your game room in some serious danger.